name is Gill Tyson and we're here at Edinburgh Printmakers. I'm a lithographer and today we've been looking at stone lithography and going through all the different stages of the process and finishing off with a final print. We have to start off by taking the stone out. The size of your image dictates the size of the stone that you're going to be working on. Once you've got the stone on the graining sink, you grind it through several layers of grit going down through grades. Firstly, to remove the image and then to produce a very fine surface on the stone, which will be sensitive to grease. So then we need to file the edges of the stone in order to produce a beveled edge to stop any ink collecting around the edge and to protect the tympan and the press when we come to printing it. Once the stone's dry, we can then start thinking about our image. We draw on the stone where the image is going to go and the registration marks for where we're going to put the paper down. And then we mix up a mixture which is called touche. I'm then going to flood part of the image with water and to drag the paste across to do my drawing. So then we leave the image to dry, and it's quite a good idea to leave it even overnight. We powder it with French chalk just to protect the image, and then we'll go on to etch the image with a mixture of gum arabic and nitric acid. You then buff that down and leave it for maybe a day, and then come back, wash out the black touche with terps through the gum etch and prime it with black roller. You can then do a second etch with repeating the process, and the next thing you're going to do is you're going to be printing the image. So take it over, the stone over to the press. You dampen the stone and the non-drawn areas will repel the ink. So then you've washed out the black ink and you can roll it up in the colour of your choice, or two colours if you're very clever. And roll it up a few times, build up the ink. Put some newsprint on, take a first proof print. Do a few more until you're happy with the image, and then print your actual image onto your print.